Spirit. A very warm good morning to one and all.
And a happy Independence Day. I'm Balamanoj, along with my co-host,
Tanha.
Welcome you all to this beautiful day on behalf of Sloka family.
We are truly blessed with your presence.
It has been 75 years since we got our independence. India is developing every single day in the terms of education, economy, science and technology, sports and entertainment, and so on. And this is made possible because of numerous sacrifices and struggles on the road to freedom. On this occasion of celebrating freedom, we cordially invite you all to this event.
This is also a special occasion for us Lokites, as our leaders are getting inducted today. Shower them with your love and blessings as they begin a new chapter in their life.
We have with us our honorable chief guests, our Managing Director, Mr. Sangameshwar Gupta, our Chairman, Mr. Bidla Srinivas Reddy, our Dean, Mr. Vishwanath Reddy, our Principal, Ms. Shabnam Khan, and our CMO, Mr. Arun Don Bosco, to grace this occasion. We also invite our dear parents, students, coordinators, and you, my teachers. Welcome you all to this occasion.
Light is a symbol of brightness and prosperity. To make this day a blessed one, we invite all the dignitaries to kindle the lamp.
Deepam Jyoti Parabrahma, Deepam Sarvatamopaham, Deepe.
Here we welcome Advita Reddy for invocation dance.
Thank you.
That was exceptional, Advaita. Thank you very much. Songs have always played an undisputed role in inciting the spirit of nationalism in the hearts of millions of Indians. We invite students of Sloka Cambridge to sing A Vatan. That was wonderful performance. Thank you. Next, we invite our chairman, sir, Mr. Bidla Srinivas Reddy, to inspire our students on this occasion of Independence Day.
A very hearty blessed morning to my dear brother Chintara Sangameshwar Gupta, our honorable principals, respected teachers and staff, and last but not least to all my dear students present here. As we all know, we are gathered here to celebrate the 75th Independence Day of our India. Today, everyone from one part of our country to another part is chanting slogans of Jai Bharat Mata with great spirit and energy. It is indeed the spirit of freedom and love for the land. But we all know this freedom is hard earned. There are decades of sacrifices and struggles behind all of that. The land on which we breathe upon is thanks to the struggles of our great men in the lead of well-known figures. Freedom is a gift. It is the gift of our sacrifices, sleepless nights, brutal tortures and struggles done by our forefathers. History is an open chapter. It tells us about the sacrifices of our forefathers for this land.
Fine, sir.
Though it has been many years since our independence, let us not forget to remember the great leaders who fought for the freedom. Most importantly, let us remember the way we achieved our freedom. We were the pioneers of non-violence freedom movement in the world. Non-violence is a concept that has been preached in almost all religions. We had implemented the same under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi to attain our freedom. We achieved our freedom assertively without being aggressive. We still stand as one of the great countries and histories in the world because of our soft yet strong nature, diverse culture and values. We still land with the concept of unity in diversity, with diverse language, culture and religion. We have about 325 spoken languages and 18 official languages. We live in harmony with our 8 religions and celebrate each other's festivals with love. We welcome people from other countries with respect and care. We have not forgotten our traditions and values, and we never let one another to forget them either. Regarding the positive changes that we have achieved in 64 years, we have emerged as one of the world's largest democracy and economy. We have achieved success in the green revolution, telecom industry and space technology. Now we are an emerging power in IT. In this day of independence, let us remember how India has set an example to entire world by means of assertive freedom struggle. We may not be a wealthy power in the world, yet we are recognized as a good human beings in a great country. Everything in the world changes, but not principles of human values. India is known to be a great country that follows these principles. Let us thank great leaders who fought for our freedom assertively and for setting us as good examples. Let us thank our country for recognizing eminent researchers, especially Dr. Abdul Kalam, who was even made President of India. Such level recognition indicates how our country strives growth in all areas. Importantly, knowledge. Knowledge is always key for success and growth. Therefore, let us make a promise in this auspicious Independence Day. Let us make India our motherland shine even brighter into our future. Jai Hind! I congratulate all my dear School Council of the year 21-22.
Thank you, sir, for the thought-provoking speech.
Our boys and girls at Shloka Cambridge are here to set the stage on fire. Give them a round of applause to welcome them. welcome our innovative program coordinator, Ms. Ujwala Panjal, who is here to share her thoughts on leadership styles.
Thank you, Bala Manoj sir and Tanha ma'am. A very happy Independence Day to all of you. Today, as we are approaching to investiture ceremony, I would like to share some leadership styles with our students. Leadership is about the art of motivating, influencing, and directing people so that they work together to achieve the goal of a team or broader organization. It's important for students to experience leadership opportunities during their schooling to learn the art of building relationships within teams, defining identities, and achieving tasks efficiently. It also provides an opportunity to learn to identify and display effective communication and interpersonal skills. Today, I'm going to share about 6 different styles of leadership skills. Autocratic leadership style. The autocratic leadership style is very direct and authoritative approach. Leader attain complete authority and control over their team. Leader who adopt an autocratic style tend to lead through power. They are very goal-oriented and truly self-driven to succeed. Being a more direct style of leadership, it is possibly best used when team require closer supervision within a task rather than team setting. Visionary leadership style. When listening different leadership style in workplace, the visionary leadership style very much engages people toward a vision set out by the manager. Visionary leaders are self-confident who love to brainstorm and create new direction. Visionary leaders are confident in their ability to engineer and innovate new ideas. This approach is perfect when your team's productivity is falling and a new direction is needed. Affiliative leadership style. Affiliative leaders tend to lead through relationships. This style of leadership focuses purely on the team's relationship. They are highly team-oriented and people-focused. The affiliative leadership style is concerned with building stronger relationship, enhancing fellow members' trust, and ensuring the overall team connection is present. Democratic leadership style. The democratic leadership style are expectant of others within the team, contributing ideas to the task or project. They actively promote the involvement of other team members and listen to their opinions. Like with all style of leadership, there is a time and a place when incent from the entire team is needed. The democratic approach can encourage team cooperation, teamwork, and bring employees together by allowing team members to have a say. When members have a say, they feel slightly more valued in their job role. When executed poorly by managers, it can seem a lot of listening but very little effective action. When compared to the 6 different leadership style, the style is the least aggressive one. Peace setting leadership. Peace setting is a style of leadership when a leader leads from the front, constantly set high standard for their team and expect them to excel with minimal management. It's when, as a manager, you set a cadence for your team and demand high intensity in their performance. Dear students, keep in mind that this style of leadership is difficult to implement on long-term basis. Coaching leadership style. The coaching leadership styles provide a more long-lasting approach. As highlighted above, different leadership styles bring out both the best or the worst in term depending on when and how they are used. This leadership style focuses on developing each team's member's skill set and attributes whilst providing positive reinforcement. As Martin Luther King Jr. once said, "The function of education, therefore, is to teach one to think intensively and to think critically." Intelligence plus character, that is the goal of true education. Dear students, you have the creativity and determination to do whatever you can dream. I hope you feel proud today and confident in your ability to rise to your next challenge. I wish you all the best. Thank you.
our students have been eagerly waiting for the investiture ceremony to induct young, bright and enthusiastic leaders. We invite Ujjwala ma'am to take over.
The problem solvers, the creative minds and the future entrepreneurs. I would like to welcome our innovation officers. Srina. I would like to welcome our Health and Wellbeing Officer, Janvi Sharma. Anbika Reddy. Officer Gautam Rathod. And the future environmentalist of Shloka, I would like to welcome environmental guardian Srimini Mahalakshmi. Bala Srinivas. Thank you.
touch her. And the future team leader of Shloka, digital assembly organizer Surya Tej Pant. Assembly organizer Harshan. The future of Da Vinci's, of Shloka. The painter and the future Da Vinci's of Shloka. I would like to welcome our art ambassador, Shanay Patel. Thank you. Art Ambassador Chinmila Bhargav Reddy. As the future public servant of India, I would like to welcome Community Service Ambassador Nivriti. Organizers of Shloka, I would like to welcome Cultural Secretary Shrutika.
Okay. Yes, sir, sir.
The writer, the editor, and the future journalist of Shloka. I would like to welcome our chief of archives, Anam. She performs her all duties with sincerity and dedication. Please welcome our junior duchess, Riti Mandani. Our junior duke, Abdul Aziz Khan. Cheerful. Please welcome our chief judge. Duchess Purnadeshwari. And a learner. Please welcome Chief DO K. Sai Aditya Reddy. Now I would like to welcome Duke and Duchess of Cambridge. Orpheus reader with a great communication and philosopher, Om Aryan Acharya. Approachable, friendly, considerate and a big sister for little Shlokite, Mahalakshmi Reddy.
Mr. Vishwanath Reddy, our CMO, Mr. Arun invest 40% of your time on leading yourself first. And for this, before I could go ahead and make you take the oath, I have three important steps that you have to start your journey of leadership in your life. The first one is self-awareness, self-reflection, and self-evaluation. So before we appoint each of you as a leader of Shloka Cambridge, I would like you to take two our core values. By now you might have appointed that to be a leader, you need to transform the school into a great school. To transform the school into a great school, you need to transform yourself. And you must also know that you need to practically practice ethical leadership. In order to do the Shloka Cambridge, core values of Student Council Committee will guide you for this. So be prepared to lead through innovation, pursue excellence, and grow by learning and be a global citizen. I would like to begin our most awaited event of badging and taking an oath from our children, the young leaders out there. So I would say and congratulate, please take up yourself to take this leading role for being a young leader of Shloka Cambridge. So wishing all the students of Shloka Cambridge a very successful tenure with great faith that they may add value to our lives and bring great laurels and pride to their families as well as to the school and make them proud to say that you are our young leaders of Shloka Cambridge. The journey starts now. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for setting the right example for our young leaders. Next, we will move on to the oath-taking ceremony. We now invite Ujwala ma'am to take over.
Mr. Vishwanath Reddy, to bless our students with his graceful words.
A very good morning, my dear children, staff and parents of Shloka. Good morning, MD sir and chairman sir, who is chief guest and guest of honor of today's event, Investiture Ceremony 2021. Why it is so important to all of us, this Investiture Ceremony? It is the first step of your life. You are taking certain responsibility of the school in certain way. I request head boy, head girl, captains, dukes, duchess, vice captains, and whatever the roles you got, you have to take the responsibility and you need to execute it as much accurate as you can. I'll give you an example of my own. I was an SPL in my school. SPL means school people leader. I feel proud that it was very memorable moment to me even today. That made me to stand today in front of you all. Leaders should have following qualities: responsibility, serving nature, helping nature, problem solving skill, binding and holding the team, responding nature, respecting each other and everyone also, punctuality and discipline, and finally good communication skills. Above all qualities you have, so that you have elected as a school council today. I request you all, the young leaders who are taken oath today, please keep in the mind, first is the nation, next is our family. Jai Hind, thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your blessings.
Are you all ready to hear from our Duke of Shloka, Cambridge? Here he is to share his thoughts with us. Let us welcome Om Aryan Acharya, the Duke of Shloka, Cambridge, with a round of applause.
A great leader inspires people to do great things. Good morning to all. I am Om Aryan Acharya of Stage 3-IGCSE. Feeling gratitude and not expressing it is like wrapping a gift and not giving it. This occasion would never be complete for us, the newly elected leaders of Shloka International School, without expressing our immense gratitude. On behalf of all the newly inducted leaders, I express sincere gratitude to everyone who has given us this opportunity. We are truly honored to be the leaders of this institution. I express my sincere gratitude to our chairman, Mr. Pitla Srinivas Reddy sir, our MD Sangameshwar Gupta sir, our Dean Mr. Vishwanath Reddy sir, and CMO Mr. Arun Kumar. Thank you for believing in me and deeming me fit to take on the responsibility of the head boy for this institution. Heartfelt gratitude to our dear principal, Shabnam ma'am, who has been a leading light. I aspire to serve Shloka as efficiently as you have led us all of these years. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you to my parents for being constantly supportive, and an abundance of gratitude to our coordinators and teachers for being the pillars of my strength. I am thankful to all the non-teaching staff for their relentless support. And last but not least, I thank each one of you here. We are here to serve and represent you. I promise to do the best to address your concerns, solve your problems, and showcase your talents. Explore, experience, and empower yourselves. Thank you. I am honored to be your head boy.
Thank you, Aryan, for your valuable words.
Let us now welcome Mahalakshmi, the Duchess of Shloka, Cambridge, to share her precious words. Give her a round of applause.
Go.
Your action inspires others to dream more, learn more, and do more. You are a leader. Good morning to all. I am Mahalakshmi from Stage 3-IGCSE. Standing here today, I simply cannot put into words the happiness, pride, and honor I feel to be addressing you as the head girl, Stoka, Cambridge. I express my sincere gratitude to our chairman, Mr. Ritla Srinivas sir, and Sangameshwar Gupta sir, and our dean, Mr. Anand sir, and our CMO, Arun sir. Your words have inspired us to be selfless, loyal, determined, and faithful leaders to make a positive impact on Stoka by being better versions of ourselves. I extend my sincere thanks to our dear principal, Shabnam ma'am, who has instilled such capabilities in me that I feel confident to be able to discharge my duties and responsibilities as the head girl of one of the prestigious schools, Stoka, Cambridge. To our teachers who laid the foundation and to our non-teaching staff, thank you. My parents have always been there for me through the thick and thin. A bouquet of gratitude to all my friends whom today we have sworn to serve and represent. I wish to serve you to the best of my ability and help you take pride in yourselves and everything that you do. My role is to stand by you, drive you to draw out the passion in you and help you in any way possible. I look forward to working with you collectively. In the words of Henry Ford, coming together is the beginning, keeping together is progress, and working together is success. Let us work with the spirit of camaraderie and make this year one that will be remembered. Thank you and happy Independence Day.
Thank you, Mahalakshmi.
It is time to hear the words of appreciation from our CMO, Mr. Arun Dunbosco, sir.
A pleasant morning, dear parents, teachers and students, and respected Chairman, MD, and Dean and Principals. Trust you are doing well and are safe in these unprecedented times. While we cope with the new normal that COVID has landed us all in, it gives me immense pleasure to see how efficiently the entire investiture ceremony of 2021-22 was carried out. This precision comes with a lot of planning, rehearsal and delivery, and so congratulations all in order for the leaders who worked to make this virtual coronation possible. I'd like to thank our parents for being with us to witness the investiture ceremony of their child, and I'm sure it was a very proud moment in each family. This indeed a challenge and responsibility to be proud of. The first step to being a student leader in the school starts with one having a brave heart. This is because many student leaders are greenhorns at the beginning of their leadership journey. I'm glad to see a good mix of new leaders coupled with some experienced returning leaders. The stage is set for some great teamwork. Speaking of leadership training and development, the dean and the principals will be hosting a number of leadership workshops to broaden the understanding and develop leadership skills. All student leaders must now become excellent time managers, as they will be double-hatting between roles as students and leaders. It is possible with proper planning, prioritizing, working with the resilience, and of course balancing relaxation and humor. Sure, a tall ask it seems now, but rest assured, not insurmountable. I've seen over the years how students have excelled in their academics and leadership while not compromising on family time and self-development. I'm sure this lot of leaders will exceed all expectations. Leadership is more about what others don't see than what they do see. I'd like to conclude with a quote by our very own Stoka International School spearhead, Chairman said, "All leaders out there, while knowing is good, doing is better, but adding value is the best. Be the best." Here, wishing all the student leaders of SIS a very successful tenure. With great faith, they may add value to our lives to bring great laurels and pride to their alma mater and families. All the best. Sanat Arun Kumar, CMO, Stoka International School.
Thank you, sir, for motivating our newly selected leaders with your words of advice.
We now invite our coordinator, Ms. Shivani Rawat, to deliver the declaration speech.
If your actions create a legacy that inspires others to dream more, learn more, do more, and become more, then you are excellent as a leader. Good morning, everyone. Spectacular day, the galaxy. parents, beloved students, how beautiful this day is. Today, we announce our student council. By giving this role in student council, we trust you that you will be student leaders who are ready to step up and serve the school in various capacities, while setting yourself up as an outstanding role models for your peers every day. But before that, ask these questions every day. Have I lived up to the expectations for which I was selected? How can I even be more better as a leader? For example, you see a fellow student who needs help in some way. Would you go forward and help that student? Because you don't know that student, would you take that step? When there is no teacher around, would you behave in the same manner without a teacher? Or your behavior would be different? Such reflections are going to be important to help you as a grow as a leader. You may make mistakes along the way. There may be times when you would be reminded that you would not live up to our expectations. Hence, here are three simple ways or steps to which you can try to improve your leadership qualities. What are these three steps or three mantras to become a good leader? Be proactive. Take initiatives. Go forward. Talk to your teachers and ask where they need to help out, where they want to go and take a step and make things better. Second mantra, challenge yourself. No matter how easy or how difficult things are, step up and ask. Ask yourself that, am I doing the right thing? Am I challenging myself? The third mantra is, communicate effectively and confidently. Even if you are doing effectively, but make sure that you are confident enough as you carry out on your duties. To conclude this, let me wish you all a very enjoyable and enriching term as a student council. Thank you and have a nice day. Thank you, ma'am.
We now hand it over to Ujwala ma'am to announce the competition results.
Thank you.
lovely and warm morning and a happy Independence Day to you, our most valued and worthy guests, coordinators, teachers, students and the parents. I, on behalf of my Shloka Cambridge family, first of all, spread my most sincere thanks to the Lord God for making this event a great success. I want to thank the chief guest, our MD Sir, Mr. Sangameshwar Gupta, who gave his time from his busy schedule to grace this meeting. I want to thank Mr. Srinivas Reddy, our beloved chairman, sir, for his time and valuable words. I also extend my gratitude towards our dean, Mr. Vishwanath Reddy, sir, our principal, Mrs. Shabnam, ma'am, and our CMO, Mr. Arun, sir, for the tremendous support and kind leadership. I also thank all the speakers, Mrs. Ujwala, ma'am, our Duke, Om Aryan, and Duchess Mahalakshmi, for adorning this necessary work and sharing with us their graceful thoughts. Further, a big thanks to Ms. Shivani Rawat, our Shloka Cambridge coordinator, for being the backbone for the success of this event. I also thank Masters of the Ceremony, Mr. Manoj, Ms. Tanha, for the efforts towards today's anchoring with the appreciating ideas. I mention my sincere thanks to Mr. Digvijay sir for his technical support. I would like to place my hearty thanks to all the participators because of whom we made this meeting possible. I also want to thank all the teachers, inductor leader of Shloka Cambridge, for the cooperation in making this event a grand one. We are fortunate to thank the dedicated and well-motivated admin team of our school who are aware of the task and are very concerned about the results. I cannot give thanks to everyone for the participation and mobility to take on the accomplishment of this meeting work. This is much varying on the vote of thanks to express my emotions that correctly fits the atmosphere. So I show the appreciation to the students and parents who have been the strength of this investiture ceremony. Once again, I would like to state that we are glad to have you all here with us. We thank you for being with us. It has remained a pronounced pleasure. Have a great day ahead.